This is an epid lion, a larva of a green lacewing. Look at all those piles of debris and waste materials it carries on its back. Due to such baggages of waste materials carried by these insects on their back, these insects are also known as junk bug. The junk bugs are ferocious serial killers, and the proof of their kill are the junk they carry on their back, which consists mostly of the dead bodies of their victims. The corpses they carry on their back help the junk bug to camouflage themselves, which enables them to move close to their prey and hunt them down. The aphids are the major source of diet for the junk bugs, but they also prey upon other small insects and also eat eggs of other bugs. Here it appears that the junk load on the back of this aphid lion has been caught in a spider's silk, and it is trying to free them from the spider's silk. After getting itself freed, the aphid lion starts to walk away. But again it gets caught in a spider's silk. It hurriedly frees itself from the sticky silk of the spider. Then it rearranges the pieces of junk on its back. And then it heads straight towards the nearby fire ant colony. Unaware of the aphid lion, the fire ants are busy in their daily activity. It appears that the fire ants are shifting their eggs. As the aphid lion enters the fire ant territory, it seems to make a final adjustment of its junk baggage, as if it was checking its armor before entering the war zone. The reason for the concern of the aphid lion soon becomes obvious. The fire ants begin to notice the presence of the aphid lion in their territory. But every time the fire ants attack, all they come across is dead and hollow remains of some insect. So they just move on, leaving the aphid lion alone. However, it appears that some of the ants are not convinced. Maybe they cannot believe that the lifeless dead bodies of insects can move. Suddenly, bigger sized ants begin to attack the aphid lion. However, even the bigger ants are not being able to penetrate the armor of the aphid lion. However, this ant is not letting go and is biting the pieces of junk on the aphid lion's back in great anger. But ultimately, seeing no effect of any kind, it just leaves the aphid lion and walks away. This encounter of the aphid lion with the fire ant is showing us the importance of the junk baggage of the aphid lion for its survival. They not only help him in camouflage, but are excellent defense against predators. The aphid lion has now reached the main nest of the fire ants. There are a lot of fire ants out here. The fire ants guard their nest very aggressively. They will not tolerate the presence of the intruder near their nest. The fire ant attack the aphid lion, but all they find is waste and debris. So they just walk away, letting go the aphid lion, thus fooling the ant with its camouflage. The aphid lion passes through much of the fire ant territory without much problem. But then it reaches the part of the nest where the grains of mud are slippery. Due to the weight of the load on its back and its long body, the aphid lion slips down right into the nest of the fire ant. The fire ants surround the aphid lion. They start biting him, but somehow the aphid lion manages to climb out. Hurriedly, it tries to leave the place, but again it slips badly and falls back right into the nest of the fire ants. The soft skin of the aphid lion looks exposed. This time, it looks like it is the end of this aphid lion. But shockingly, it climbs out of the nest unharmed for the second time. However, this time there is a fire ant walker in its back, which is ferociously trying to get through the armor of the aphid lion. Other ants also come and join her. Will they be able to penetrate the armor of this aphid lion? But when all attempts of the fire ants to puncture the armor of the aphid lion fail, the fire ants seem to lose in their interest and they leave one by one. Taking advantage of the opportunity, the aphid lion makes a swift retreat and climbs up a bamboo twig lying nearby. But what actually is this apid lion doing around a fire ant nest? Why is it taking all these risks? Why the hell is it putting its life in such a grave danger? Well, I don't have answers for any of these questions. When I last saw the apid lion, as I left the place, it was peacefully resting on the bamboo twig right above the fire ant nest. Few days later, when I returned to this place, I was shocked to see this. I saw an apid lion that was covered completely in the dead bodies of the fire ants. Now what was going on here? Was this apid lion hunting down ants? Was this the same apid lion that we had seen before? Frankly speaking, I do not know. It's just difficult to believe that this apid lion killed all of these ants. But then, how the hell did all of these ant corpses appear on the apid lion's back? Well, it's confusing. Can any one of you help me out? Do post your comment in the comment box below. Till then guys, do take care of yourself and stay safe.